Well, good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for coming over. I've joined the director's briefing today, although this will be his briefing. As many of you know, the news from San Bernardino continues to evolve, and obviously we now have seen the names and faces of those victims, of those, the fallen and the injured, and as always, our hearts go out to them, and let's keep them in our prayers, not just those who did lose their lives, but also those who were injured in this, including our law enforcement officials. As we've always told you about this matter, it is an evolving investigation. We also told you we'd keep you informed about this investigation. Just recently, there was a press conference in the local area with the assistant director in charge of the Los Angeles office providing more operational details. The director is going to give you a further briefing as well. As you saw from that, and as we indicated yesterday, the FBI has taken the lead in this investigation. They continue to work with our local partners, who are outstanding partners, along with the ATF and U.S. Marshals, as well as we continue to investigate this. There's been a lot of new information that's come to light, and the director's going to give you some more insight into that. So thank you all for being here today.
Thank you, Madam Attorney General. Let me begin by echoing the Attorney General's remarks. Our hearts continue to ache for the people lost and wounded in San Bernardino and their families. And I also want to say a word of gratitude and say how impressed we were with the response of local law enforcement in San Bernardino. They were simply amazing. We are all very lucky that really good people become police officers in this country. And then I want to also say a word of thanks to the folks we don't talk about much, which are the people who rendered emergency care and aid, the EMTs, the docs, the nurses, the victim specialists. Those are people who are the angels of our business and don't get the thanks they deserve. So thank you to them. We're here today because we want to make sure you understand that this is now a federal terrorism investigation led by the FBI. And the reason for that is that the investigation so far has developed indications of radicalization by the killers and of a potential inspiration by foreign terrorist organizations. And we are spending a tremendous amount of time, as you might imagine, over the last 48 hours trying to understand the motives of these killers and trying to understand every detail of their lives. We are going through a very large volume of electronic evidence. This is electronic evidence that these killers tried to destroy and tried to conceal from us, that we now have and are exploiting to try and understand them. We are keeping our minds open, as we always try to do. I know that there are a lot of good questions that folks want answers for quickly, but I hope you know about our work. We aspire to do it quickly, but we most of all aspire to do it well and do it carefully. There's a lot of evidence in this case that doesn't quite make sense, and so we're trying to be very thoughtful to understand it and to make sense of it so we understand the full extent of what we have here. Let me offer you, though, a couple of specifics on the investigation. First, our investigation to date, and again, it's only 2 days old, so far we have no indication that these killers are part of an organized larger group or form part of a cell. There's no indication that they are part of a network. Again, I quickly add, it is early. We're still working very hard to understand, but I want you to know that so far we don't see such indications. Second, there is nothing in our holdings about these two killers. I have seen reporting where folks have focused on reports that they were in contact, at least one of the killers was in contact with people who had been the subject of FBI investigations, either investigations that were closed or that were still open. I would urge you not to make too much of that. There were no contacts between either of the killers and subjects of our investigations that were of such a significance that it raised these killers up onto our radar screen. We're obviously looking very closely at those contacts, but I would not want you to over-index on that just yet. It is, as I said, 48 hours old. There is much about this that doesn't make sense to even for even those of us who do this for a living. That is the reason we have hundreds of people running down leads all over the world on this and spending tremendous amounts of time as we sit here trying to understand the electronic record around these two killers. Let me close by saying something the Attorney General and I have said before, and that is we know that this is very unsettling for the people of the United States. What we hope you will do is not let fear become disabling, but to instead try to channel it into an awareness of your surroundings to get you to a place where you are living your life, but if you see something that doesn't make sense, you say something to somebody. when we look back over our cases over the last 10, 15 years, in almost every case, we find that somebody saw something, whether it was a family member or a friend or a coworker, and didn't say something to law enforcement, wrote an innocent narrative over some facts that were making them feel uncomfortable or making the hair stand up on the back of their necks. Please don't do that. We have worked very, very hard since 9/11 to get ourselves to a place where if you tell a police officer or a deputy sheriff or call the FBI and say, you know, I saw something next door that seems off, or I saw something online that seems off, it will get to the right people, and we will investigate it quickly and responsibly. We investigate in secret so that we don't smear innocent people. We don't run over and bang on your neighbor's door if you say something. We investigate. If there was nothing there, no harm done. If there was something there, great harm may be avoided. So we would ask you, please channel that sense of fear into something healthy, just an awareness of your surroundings, and let us do the work that you pay us to do, which is to investigate and fight terrorism while you live the lives that are so wonderful in this great country of ours. Thank you for this, and we'll take your questions.